Hey family, my name's Amanda, for those of you who don't know me, and I'm giving today's just mini devotional for you to consider and think upon. I originally had planned on giving a different devotional, but just felt that I was supposed to be reading this portion of scripture instead, so bear with me if it's not as refined and all that kind of stuff. I just kind of wanted to start off with where it is in scripture. I'll be reading from Luke 18, verses 1 through 8. And it goes like this. Then Jesus told his disciples a parable to show them that they should always pray and not give up. He said, "In a certain town there was a judge who neither feared God nor cared about men. And there was a widow in the town who kept coming to him with the plea, 'Grant me justice against my adversary.' For some time he refused, but finally he said to himself, 'Even though I don't fear God or care about men, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will see that she gets justice, so that she won't eventually wear me out with her coming.' And the Lord said, 'Listen to what the unjust judge says. And will not God bring about justice for his chosen ones who cry out to him day and night? Will he keep putting them off? I tell you, he will see that they get justice and quickly. However, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on the earth?" This is something that I've been praying through and thinking through a lot, especially during the season that we've been going through. And I know for myself, I take comfort in it saying that God will bring about justice for us if we're persistent in crying out to him day and night. And I know for me, there's been a lot of crying, and that doesn't even compare to others. And yet, I know while in this text it says he'll bring about it quickly, our definition of time and his definition of time are different. But yet at the same time, seeing what changes have been made in an earthly standpoint has been amazing to see. But I also know that there's even more that's to be done, but most of it's going to need to be done by God. It's not something man can manufacture themselves. It's something only God can rectify. And so that has honestly been my prayer through a lot of this season, through everything that's been going on, and something that I continue to pray on. And so I guess I just want to encourage you all to be praying as well, to cry out to God. And I know we all have different convictions on what we're supposed to be doing during this season, but going to God with all of it is also necessary as well. So I just want to encourage you all that I'm praying, praying for you if I know you, and then still praying even if I don't. So I'd actually like to pray for y'all right now. So Lord, thank you that you are a good and just God, even in the times that we may not see it directly. Lord, I know and trust that you are, and you know what you are going to bring about during this season. You know what the outcome is going to be, and you're going to control every step of the way and bring about the justice that needs to be done. I ask for those who are hurting, Lord, right now during this season, that you would draw near to them. Not take away their pain necessarily, but let them know that you are with them, Lord, that you are by their side and that you fight for them. And just let all of us know that we are loved by you. We are your children, Lord, and we love you, Lord. In your name we pray.